could join us today for Letterland. This is our first day of Unit 1. So some of the things that we're going to work on today may look like things that we did before or that we did in kindergarten. And then I'm going to spin this around, and some of the things that are back here on my other pocket chart are going to be totally new and different. So I need your brains turned up extra, extra high today, because this is going to be something that we do from today through the rest of the year. Anytime we get ready to rock and roll with a new unit, like I said, this is Unit 1, this is what our day ones are gonna look like, and it's a lot. So give me a thumbs up if you're ready. Awesome. So we're gonna start our day with our quick dash, okay? So remember, quick dash is where I ask you the name of the letterlander and the sound, all right? So we're gonna try and go pretty quick. We're not gonna get through all of our letters because it's quick dash. Ready? Who's this? Annie Apple. What sound? Ah. Who's this? Clever Cat. What sound? Who's this? Dippy Duck. What sound? Duh. Going backwards, gonna trick you. Who's this? Bouncy Ben. What sound? Firefighter Fred. What sound? With his foam, his firefighting foam. And again, if you haven't tuned into our live Letterlands and you're new to Snipes, some of this stuff might be new for you. So you might want to back up and watch some of the other Letterland videos before you try and rock and roll with us on this one. Who's this? Hairy Hat Man. What sound? Very quiet. Who's this? Lucy Lamplight. What sound? Ooh, good job. Almost done. Who's this? Munching Mike. What sound? And notice how we always say the sounds when we see their playing side. We only say their names when we're looking at the characters. Okay, so yes, this is Munching Mike, but when we see the playing letter, we make his sound. Good job. Okay, remember, I'm gonna bounce around. Who's this? Peter Puppy. What sound? Puh. Who's this? Red Robot. What sound? Like you're running. Who's this? Noisy Nick. What sound? Bang that nail. Good job. Couple more. Who's this? Sammy Snake. What sound? Who's this? Talking Tess. What sound? Good job. And I think that's it. I think that's all we're going to do for our quick dash today. Because what I really want to focus on is starting to use these letterlanders to build words and read words, because that's our job in reading, is to become good readers, and we use all of these letterland characters and their sounds to put together the words that we might see in the books that we're trying to read, okay? So I want you to notice my reading direction sign is pointing this way, and most of my letterlanders face this way. There's a couple that we're gonna get to that are kind of breaking the rules and they face the other way, but we'll talk about them when we get there, okay? So when we read, we're gonna go in the reading direction. Same thing when we write. Okay, go in this way. So the first word that I want us to work on is at. Let's say the sounds together, ready? At, okay? Notice how I'm using my hand to help myself say those sounds. Ah, and I'm touching the first one, but I'm letting it look at me so that I can see it going in the reading direction. At, okay? That way when I go to write with my writing hand, I can still use this tool to help myself. Okay, so my writing hand is free to hold a pencil if I needed to, and my other hand, the hand that I don't use for writing, is looking at me. So if you use this hand to do your writing, okay, you're going to turn this other hand out so that it's going in the reading direction, all right? So you have to kind of find what's comfortable for you. So I'm going to use this one so that it's looking at me, so that when I go to write, I have this hand free. Ready? At. One more time. At. So I need to find a for Annie Apple and t. Talking Tess, you're right. But I'm not going to leave them as Annie Apple and Talking Tess. I'm going to flip them around so we can see the plain letter sign. Ready? Read this word with me. At. Great job. Now, I'm going to put a letter in front of at so that I can change this word and make it just a little bit longer. So you're still going to hear the at sound in it, but it's going to have a different sound up front. The word I want to make is mat. Ready? Make a totally different word like rat. Can you think of what you would do to make rat? R-at, rat. Red robot. You're right. Say the sounds with me. Slide through all the sounds in that word. Great job. So we made at, then we made mat, then we made rat. I bet we can make one more. Let's try the word bat. Tap those sounds in bat with me. B. At. Bat. What's missing? B, b, b. Bouncy. Ben starts the word bat, and the rest of my letters stay the same because those words all sound alike, so I would need the same sounds in them to make them sound alike. Ready? B. At. Bat. And we had a song in kindergarten about words that sounded alike. In my room, it went like this. Okay, let's pretend that we had rat and bat. We would say rat, bat, sound alike except where they begin. Rhyming, 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 middle and the end. Because we only change the beginning sound. So it goes like this. Rat, bat, sound alike except where they begin. Rhyming, 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 middle and the end. Because the middle and the end is what's staying the same. So we're going to put Bouncy Ben back and Red Robot back. Because now, instead of looking at things that have at in them, I'm going to change this ending sound. Put Talking Tess back here. And we're going to make a silly nonsense word with Peter Puppy at the end. Let's tap these sounds and see if we can figure out this silly nonsense word. It doesn't say at anymore. It says at. In your world, that might not be a silly made-up nonsense word because an app is something that you use on the iPad. It's spelled a little bit differently, but it does sound like this word, app. So now we're going to add some things to the front of app to make some new words. Are you ready? First word I want to make is lap. Ooh, app. Ooh, app. Need in the beginning of this word to make it say lap. Lucy Lamplight's letter says ooh. So I'm going to flip her around so I can't see her, just the plain side, to make this word ooh, app, lap. What if I wanted to change lap to map? I wouldn't need ooh in the front, lap. I want it to say map. What would you use for that? You're right. I would need Munching Mike to say at the beginning of map. Let's check this one. M-a-p. Map. You did a great job. Now, what if here I got a little tricky? Okay? Because map and lap were rhyming words. They sound alike. I'm going to change instead the ending sound. No more map. I got Dippy Duck. Mad. mad as my last word, like when your face is really angry. Stretch this with me. Mad. Mad. You got it. So, friends, I want to spin you around now because I don't want to take too long on this side. I am really excited for you to see what's happening on the other side. So I'm going to borrow some of these Letterland characters. We're going to need Annie Apple. We're going to need Dippy Duck. We're going to need Peter Puppy. And we're going to need Talking Tess. And then the rest of the Letterlanders that we need are already over there. Okay, so let's spin around. So that you can see, I have words already spelled out on this side of my pocket chart. And the reason that they are like that in these rows is because they fit with a family, okay? When we stick a group of letters together and we keep them together to make words that sound alike, we call that a family. Just like you come into the classroom, you stick together with your friends, we have a class family. When you go home, you have your home family, you stick together. So when letters live together in a family, they sound alike. So in this column, we have Annie Apple and Dippy Duck in all of our words. So all of the words in this family are gonna say add. Add. So let's see if we can go through and check and make sure that all of these say add in them. Okay, hopefully you can see. Tap with me. D. Add. Dad. Does sound like add. Dad. Check this one. Add. Mad. Hey, we made that on the other side. Mad. So we had dad, mad, and then this one has Harry Hatman in the front. Let's try this. Add. Had. Dad, mad, had. They all sound alike because they all live in the same family. They all rhyme. So we could say, dad, mad, had sound alike except where they begin. Rhyming, 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 rhyming. Middle and the end. Because we were changing the beginning sound and keeping add. Okay? So now I'm going to leave Dippy Duck over here. And I'm going to put Peter Puppy above these words because I can see Peter Puppy is at the end of all of them. And I need Annie Apple to come over here with me again for these words. Okay? So all of these words are going to end with app. Just like we did on the other side with an app. Right? So the beginning sound is going to be what changes. And we need to make some real words with the sound app in that family. Ready? Tap them and try and solve them with me. N-app. N-app. Nap. I love naps. Okay? I do hear app at the end of that word. Let's check the next one. This one has Munching Mike in the front. Ready? Tap it with me. N-app. Map. Map. You got it. So nap with Noisy Nick and then map with Munching Mike. Make sure you can feel the difference in your mouth between nap and map because they sound almost exactly the same. Nap, map, like what you would use to find out where you're going. And then the last one has Lucy Lamplight in the front. Let's try this one. Ooh, ah. Ooh, app. Ooh, app. Ooh, lap. You got it. So if you can read nap, then you can also read map and lap because all you have to change is that beginning sound. So we say nap, nap, lap. Nap, nap, lap sound alike except where they begin. Rhyming, 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 rhyming. Middle and the end, because we kept the app in the middle and the end to make them rhyme. It's time for our last group of words over here. Okay? And these are the ones that all have Talking Tess at the end. So again, Peter Puppy's going to say in this family over here, Dippy Duck stayed in this family over here. This is going to be talking Tess's family, okay? So we carried Annie Apple from this house to this house, now over here to this house, because we need her in this family too. Okay, let's see if we can figure out what her family is all about for talking Tess. Hers is the at. The at family. And at is actually our first word in this family because it is a word by ourselves. Okay? At. But let's put a sound in front of at and see what this says. Tap it with me. K. At. One more time. Like clever cat. Good job. And then the last word we're going to use in this family is s-at. S-at. Sat. Like when you sit down on something, we could say she sat, he sat. They all have at in them because they live in this family. They sound alike. They rhyme. Sing it with me. At, cat, sat. At, cat, sat, sound alike, except where they begin. Rhyming, 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 middle and the end. So I'm going to turn Talking Tess back around. And I want to point out Annie Apple to you. I want you to notice how Annie Apple lived here, but she also lived here, and she lived over there too. That's because she's a vowel. I want you to say that word back to me. Vowel with Vicky Violet sound in the front. Vowel. Good job. We're going to talk more about vowels a little bit later, but I just want you to remember that Annie Apple is one of those special letters because she goes in a lot of words. Every word has to have a vowel. That's why I need Annie Apple in all of these places. Okay? Now, we are going to play a special game today that has to do with reading. And there's going to be some other things that we use too, like a tractor and a train and a plane and a helicopter. Can you believe that? Hang on, let me get those out. I'm gonna put Annie Apple back there for just a second so that you can see my pictures. What is this? It is a tractor. So when we read like a tractor, okay, we push through the words really slow, because tractors move really slow as they push through the field, right? It's kind of like boom, boom, boom. So when we read like a tractor, we're going to go pretty slow. So we have to practice reading all of these words as a tractor, because that's the first step in being a reader, is to solve the words and figure them out. And to do that, we have to go slow. But then, oh, that's not quite right. Hang on. Hold the phone. You're right. Then we're going to read like a train. Trains move faster than tractors. They're kind of slow and steady. Not like a zippy, speedy train, okay? Just like a train that's chugging along on the track, okay? Nice and smooth. So my tractor is where I solve the word, and my train is when I just read it. Like a regular reading voice. So we'll read all of these words like a train. Then we have a plane. Now, planes move really fast. They are what take you from one side of the country to somewhere else in just a few hours. If you look up and you see a plane in the sky, whew, it's gonna zip right over your head. I know that we go to school really close to the airport here, so we see a lot of these, and they do move really fast. So when we read like a plane, we're just gonna zip right through these words like this. Boom, 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 boom. That's going to be our plane. And then the last one's pretty crazy. I don't know if you've ever seen one of these, okay? This is a helicopter. And the cool thing about helicopters is they don't really have to, like, take off like a plane would. They just kind of go straight up in the air, and then they go somewhere else. And they go straight up in the air, and they hop somewhere else. So when we read, like, a helicopter, we're not going to read all the words in our list in order. We're going to kind of bounce around, because by the time we get to helicopter, we should be able to remember and read all of these words. So I'm going to get a little closer so that you can see them a little bit better. Okay? And we're going to start with my tractor. Okay? So again, when we read like a tractor, we're going to go through all the sounds in the word. Ready? D. Add. Dad. Good job. Try this one. Mad. Mad. Good. Try this one. Add. Had. All right. So now we're going to switch to the train and try and read these a little bit faster. Ready? Dad. Mad. Had. Very good. Now we're going to switch to our plane. Remember, our plane goes pretty fast. Dad. Mad. Had. You got it. Let's try it with our helicopter. Our helicopter is what bounces all around. Ready? Had. Dad. Mad. Dad. Had. We're going to come back to the helicopter a little bit later once we read all of these. Now I'm going to move on to my next family, and I'm going to go back to the tractor. Okay? Remember, the tractor goes nice and slow. Read it with me. N-a-p. N-a-p. Good job. Try this one with me. Ready? M-a-p. M-a-p. Way to go. Last one down here. L-a-p. L-a-p. Good job. Now we're going to switch over to the train, and we're going to go a little bit faster. Ready? Nap. Map. Lap. And hopefully you're reading along with me. Great job. Now we're going to switch to that airplane, and we're going to go super fast. Ready? Nap. Map. Lap. And helicopter. Helicopters bounce around. So, map, lap, nap, lap, map, and it's going to bounce back over here. Mad, had, dad, lap, nap. Oh, great reading. Okay, time for our last family. For our last family, we go back to the tractor to start. Ready? Nice and slow. Say these sounds. At. At. K. At. Cat. S. At. Sat. Good job. All right, switching to my train side, going a little bit faster. Not too fast yet, though. Ready? At. Cat. Sat. Good job. Now we can go fast with our plane. At. Cat. Sat. Good job. It's time to bring out that helicopter. Remember, he bounces around. He gets tricky. Ready? Cat. Map, nap, lap, at, dad, had, mad. You can play this game on Seesaw. There's going to be something called a student list, and you're going to need this list all week, because these words that you see right here are going to be the words that I ask you to write all by yourself on our spelling test at the end of this week. So you're going to want to practice reading these words and spelling these words over and over and over again, so that when we get to the end on day 5, you'll feel really, really good about reading and spelling these. So you'll see a picture of a tractor and a picture of a plane and a picture of a train and a picture of a helicopter on Seesaw. And you're going to see this student list on here, and I want you to do the same thing that I just did, where you practice recording your voice like a tractor, then like a train, then like a plane, then like a helicopter. Okay, leave the helicopter for the very end once you've done all of them, so then you can make the helicopter bounce all around. We're not done yet, because you may see I still have some things down here. I promise this is going to be the last thing for the day today, and then day one is always the most because I have to show you all the cool things that we're working on, okay? These guys down here are called tricky words. And the reason that they're tricky is because of the way that they're spelled. The sounds don't match the way that they look. They sound different than we would actually write them, okay? So we're gonna go through one word at a time in my tricky words and know that tapping out the sounds is not gonna help us read these words. Tricky words are words I just have to know. In kindergarten, we called them words to know when we did our morning meeting, all right? So here's my first tricky word. Let's see if you know it already. What word is this? It's the word a or a. So if I was gonna say I have a pet dog or I have a green crayon, right? Really what we're trying to say is I have a pet dog or I have a green crayon. So sometimes people get lazy and they change the sound of this letter and they just say but it's not uppy umbrella when we go to write it. It's always gonna be this letter. So sometimes people will say A when they see this in a sentence, and that's great, but sometimes people will read it or say it as so I need you to know it as both. This is A when it's a word, or right? Okay, so to help us remember how to spell these tricky words, we're gonna go through three parts. I'm gonna sit because hopefully this helps, all right? So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna write it in the air and we're going to say it out loud. Ready? I want you to get your skywriter out and I want you to write it with me and say it. A. Good. Now we're gonna do it again and we're gonna whisper it. A. Very good. And now we're just gonna write it without saying anything, but I want us to say it in our brain. This tricky word is A or A. Our next tricky word is this word. Do you know what it says? It's the word is. So some of the sounds match is. Because you know Sleepy Sammy, we just haven't met him in first grade yet. So you may be able to tap this word, but it's better to just look at it and know what it says. That word is, and you heard me use it in a sentence. That word is, okay? So we're gonna go through our three. We're gonna start by saying the letters as we skywrite it, so it's best to use two fingers and really stick your arm straight out to do it, okay? You're gonna make the letter I first, say it. I, S, is, and I like underline it as I say the whole word. Let's do it again, saying it out loud. I, S, is. Good job. Now we're going to whisper it. I, S, is. Nice. Okay? Then we're going to say the letter sounds in our head as we skywrite it. You did it. Is. Okay? So you might say, my best friend is Miss Atwood, or my favorite food is tacos. So you could definitely use this word in a sentence. Two more. This tricky word, okay, is definitely tricky because of this letter at the end. When we think of yellow yo-yo man, we think of y. But this word doesn't say me. That would be a silly word. This word is my. Why we can't tap it out. We just have to look at it and know it. Say this word, my. Okay, we're gonna skywrite the letters. M-Y, my. Whisper those letters. M-Y, my. Good job. Say them in your head as you skywrite them again. What's this word? My. Okay, very good. Like when something belongs to you. So you could say, my hair, my shoes, my pocket chart, my desk. Okay? Anything that belongs to you, you can use this word to tell that it's your own. My. My last tricky word is on, all right? The opposite of off is on, okay? And again, Oscar Orange is kind of, you can hear him, but I just want you to look at it and boop, know what it says instead of trying to stretch those sounds, okay? What's this word? On. Skywrite it with me. O-N, on. Very good. Whisper it. On. Great job. Say it in your head. You did it, and I'm so proud of you. These four words are also going to be on that student list that you see, and they're also going to be on your spelling test at the end of the week. You're going to need to be able to read them in sentences and in a story, and you're going to need to be able to spell them as well. So it's super duper important that throughout this week, you practice reading and spelling all of these words. We're going to put some of these in morning meeting as well, so that we can make sure we're always going back over them. And I'm going to show you some other fun ways to practice tricky words, so that you're not always just doing the skywriting. So we'll use that usually like Mondays, maybe at morning meeting, but then I'm going to show you some other ways to practice tricky trick words as well. So when you go to do the planes and trains and helicopters with these, okay, just remember that you can't stretch the sounds in this, so the tractor won't really work as well. You can read them slow with the tractor, but don't say the sounds. You would just say like, A is, and go really slow like that, all right? So these words that live in families, yes, you can tap out and say the sounds. These words that are tricky words do not follow our pattern for the week. We just want to look at them and know them right away. And that's it for day one of Unit 1 in Letterland. Thank you for joining me. I love you all. I hope you have a great rest of your day.